Coming up in this Brightline construction update. This update offers an aerial look at the progress at five locations along Brightline's new Orlando line that runs from Cocoa, Florida to Orlando International Airport. We'll start at Narcosi Road. Narcosi Road is just east of Orlando International Airport, and it is the first exit east of the airport on State Road 528. This is one of the more challenging locations for crews to work on this line. This is due to the small right-of-way they have to work with while having the entrance and exit ramps and Narcosi Road to deal with. Because of existing development on the edge of the right-of-way here, there is just enough room for two tracks to thread through this area. At other locations, Brightline would veer the tracks around the ramps to minimize the bridge work, but they have to go over everything here. On the east end, crews were in the process of pounding in pilings for a bridge that'll take the tracks over the entrance ramp. Pilings for another support that are already installed has forms around it in preparation for concrete. Moving back west, crews have been building up the embankment between the entrance ramp and Narcosi Road. Forms were going up on the ends of the embankments on either side of the road to form the bridge beam supporting headers. The center support is almost complete. The embankment west of Narcosi Road is farther behind, and that is because the current exit ramp is in its way. The exit ramp here will be rerouted to go under this bridge and is close to being complete. The bridge beams were recently installed here. Once the rerouting happens, the old exit ramp will be removed and the embankment completed in its place. The ramp headed down toward the airport in the top left corner looks to be complete. Next, we'll head about 3 miles east to the southeast corner of the State Road 528, State Road 417 interchange, providing a look at a section of right-of-way that is farther along. This area has subroadbed laid on the right-of-way. The next step here should be to bring in the ties. Moving west, and a bridge here looks to be close to being complete over wetlands. There is a temporary bridge on the north side of the rail bridge that gives crews access along the right-of-way. In the distance in the top left corner of the screen is the bridge over State Road 417. The next stop is the overpass over the CSX Stanton rail line. This is located 3.5 miles east of our last stop and is located at the former International Corporate Park exit from State Road 528. That exit was replaced by the new Innovation Way exit. Crews have been focused recently on building up the ramp on either side of the bridge. Since my last visit here, crews have also built a box culvert down the right-of-way, and it is now under part of the ramp. Dirt for this project is being brought in from massive borrow pits along the right-of-way in both directions. There is a constant stream of dump trucks driving down the right-of-way to bring it in. Crews have also filled in part of these retention ponds as a connection is going to be installed here to the OUC rail line, so supplies such as ballast and rail can be brought in by train. As for the bridge here, crews are working on the headers on both of the embankments to support the bridge beams. The center support between the rail line and road is complete. In the background is the OUC Stanton Energy Center, which is the reason this rail line exists in the first place, for coal deliveries. That is a controlled brush fire on the right. There is lots of activity on the ramp, with near constant deliveries of dirt and equipment spreading it out. This dozer is spreading out a pile of dirt now. Here's one of the dump trucks racing along the dirt access road going to pick up its next load. Our next stop is at Dallas Boulevard. Dallas Boulevard is located about 4 miles east of the OUC rail line. This ramp is basically complete now. In the distance, there is the worksite for the bridge over the Conlockachie River. The pilings for that bridge are in place, so crews should be working on forming the header soon. Here is an overview look along the entire ramp for this bridge. Dallas Boulevard itself has a railroad history. It was originally the right-of-way for the Florida East Coast Railway's Kissimmee Valley Extension. That line ended up being abandoned in 1947 and was subsequently turned into a road. Moving east from the bridge is where a long straight segment on the right-of-way begins. Flying up the ramp gives an idea of what the engineer's view will be. Crews are only building one half of the bridge over Dallas Boulevard right now, but the ramp is being future-proofed for eventual double tracking. Preparations are being made now to minimize the work required when it comes time to build the second half. Crews still have some work to complete on the ends of the ramp where the bridge will be built. On the right are three pilings that will support one track of the bridge. On the left, three metal pipes have been placed where the pilings will eventually go when it comes time to widen the bridge for double track. Only one support in the middle has been currently built as well. There are plans for this area to be developed in the near future, so this bridge is taking those expansion plans into account. While Dallas is currently a two-lane dirt road, it will eventually be multiple lanes in each direction. The forms around the pilings are to form the headers that will support the bridge beams. The last stop is State Road 520. State Road 520 is located about 7 miles east of Dallas Boulevard. The ramp has been expanded since my last visit. Subroadbed has also been laid along the right-of-way west of here. This is another location where the ramp is designed for double track, but the bridge will only be single tracked initially. The metal pipe stacked here will go where the pilings for the second half of the bridge will eventually go. Pilings have been installed here on the west side of State Road 520 for the first half of the bridge. A crane is currently on the east side installing pilings there. There has been no progress on starting the ramp on the east side yet. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.